Greetings and welcome to this lecture. We are going to study central air conditioning system. Now there are two types of central air conditioning system. One is direct expansion DX type and second one is chill water central air conditioning system. So today we are going to study about chilled water central air conditioning system. Next we will see chilled water central air conditioning system. Okay, very important, you should know this properly, and we are going to see the actual plant as well. Okay, so first we will study the basic plant and then we will go to the Mahindra and Mahindra plant of central AC. Okay, so understand this, and this you have to relate with that actual plant. Okay, so there are four cycles in central air conditioning system. These are refrigeration cycle, condenser water cycle, chilled water cycle and air cycle. Okay, so here refrigerant is used. Refrigerant can be either R22, it can be either R410A. Okay, so different refrigerants can be used. So first cycle is refrigeration cycle. So refrigeration cycle, what are the components that we will see? So you can observe this on the bottom side. This is refrigeration cycle. Top side we have compressor. Here we have compressor. From compressor, the hot vapor at high pressure and temperature, it goes to the condenser, which is there on the middle of this system. So what will happen, whatever refrigerant is there, it will reject its heat at constant pressure and it will get converted to liquid. If you consider the condenser, inside the shell of the condenser, refrigerant is there, and inside the tube, cooling water from the cooling tower is there. Okay, so what will happen in condenser, inside the shell of the condenser, we have vapor. It will lose its heat to the water which is there inside the tubing. And whatever refrigerant is there, that will condense. Then that condensed refrigerant at medium temperature, high pressure, liquid, it goes to the expansion device. Here thermostatic expansion valve is used. After that, there will be pressure and temperature drop, and it will enter the chiller, which is having low pressure and low temperature. Okay, it will pick up the heat from the water to be chilled. Water is the secondary refrigerant over here. So inside this tube, what is present? Refrigerant is present. And outside the tube, inside the shell, that is shell side, chilled water is present. So water is chilled over here. So this is about refrigeration cycle. So refrigeration cycle, we have compressor, condenser, expansion valve and evaporator. Next we will see condenser water cycle. So for condenser water cycle, what are the components? You can see from here, this is the outlet of the cooling tower, from where cool water is taken with the help of pump, and it is sent where? To the shell and tube heat exchanger. So inside the tube, what is flowing? Cold water is flowing, which is there at atmospheric condition. Okay, and inside the shell, what is there? Hot refrigerant in vapor form. So hot refrigerant, it gives its heat to the water, and water will become hot. It will come out of the dish tube and again it will go back to the cooling tower, and on the top of the cooling tower, the water is spread. It will fall in downward direction, and from here air blows. So water will be cooled, again it will go back to the sump. Here a float control valve is there. Suppose some of the water, it is being evaporated into the atmosphere, then makeup water is required. So here makeup water arrangement along with float valve is also given. Okay, so this is about the condenser water cycle. Next cycle is chilled water cycle. Okay, so chilled water cycle, it starts with this evaporator. Okay, now if you consider the evaporator, in the tube of the evaporator, shell and tube evaporator, there will be refrigerant. Now that refrigerant is in liquid plus vapor state. Liquid will be more, vapor will be less. And in the shell side of the evaporator, in the tube side we have refrigerant, in the shell side we have water. That water will give its heat to the refrigerant. That refrigerant will get converted into vapor, and again the refrigerant will go back to the compressor. Now coming back to the water, this chilled water inside the evaporator or chiller, it will be taken from the chiller with the help of chilled water pump and sent to this AHU. So here you can see different floors are there: ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor. Each floor AHU is there. Okay, so chilled water with the help of chilled water pump, it goes to the AHU. In the AHU, there will be cooling coil. So chilled water will flow inside the cooling coil and it will again come back from this part and enter to the shell and tube heat exchanger. Okay, so these are the components of chilled water cycle. What are the components? Chilled water pump, AHU, expansion tank, you can see on the top of the building. Here expansion tank is there. Then shell and tube type of chiller, which is there on the bottom side. Now, what is the use of this expansion tank? What happens? Here you can see what happens exactly. Now, this chilled water enters the AHU, and in AHU, what will happen? Your blower is there. This blower, it sucks the air from the backside. The air will move over the chiller coil and it gets cooled, and with the help of ducting system, it is sent to the room. So what will happen? This chilled water, it will become hot and it is sent back where? To the chiller, that is evaporator. So at the same time, you can see the return line. This is the return line for all the floors. This return line, it is connected on the terrace with the expansion tank. Now, what is the function of this expansion tank? We will see that. What happens? There are different type of expansion tank available in the market. So this is one of the photo of expansion tank shown over here. What is the function of this expansion tank? Usually, water, when it becomes chill, its volume gets reduced. So because of that, there will be a pressure differential created since volume is getting reduced. So that is why in that case, this expansion tank will provide the extra amount of water. It will enter to the evaporator or chiller. Okay, then when the power is cut off, we are turning off the central AC system. In that case, what will happen? Temperature will come to the normal condition and the temperature will increase. So there will be expansion of water. Then again, that water, it is sent back to, through the same line to the expansion tank. So excess water is again stored to the expansion tank. So this is the function of expansion tank. Now the fourth cycle we will see, which is called air cycle, which has the following components. AHU is there. So this is AHU, air handling unit. Then supply air duct is there. So here you can see air handling unit. After that, this part is the supply air duct. Then this part is the supply air diffuser, which is called air terminal units. We have seen this in duct design. So air terminal unit will be there. And after that, there will be return air diffuser. So this is return air diffuser. And here there will be a return air duct. And this return air, it is again taken back to the AHU room. Now here you can see in the AHU room, return air, it is mixing with the outside fresh air. Here there will be a damper. Okay, that damper can actually control the fresh air rate, flow rate. So return air, it mixes with the fresh air. Why return air is again taken here? Because that return air is already cool, right? Okay, so that is why we are reusing that air, so that the electricity bill is less. So return air mixes with fresh air. Again, it goes back to the AHU. Again, it is chilled and then supplied to the room with the help of ducting system. Okay, so here you can observe that part. This is the AHU room where air handling unit is there. Now inside the AHU, what happens? Here chilled water is entering. Okay, these are the cooling coils. We will see this in detail. And I have the peak of AHU as well. And then the chilled water exits from here. Again, it goes back to the chiller or vapor compression refrigeration system. At the same time, here a fan is there and blower is there. It takes the return air and fresh air. It flows over the cooling coil. It will become cool. Air will become cool. And with the help of ducting system, it is sent to the room. Again, through the return air duct, it is taken back to the AHU room. So this is the way in which chilled water, that is why this is called which type of central air conditioning system? Chilled water central air conditioning system. Where primary refrigerant, it can be anything like R22, it is not being used right now, R410, etc. And here secondary refrigerant is water. Now you can understand clearly over here, this application is which application? Air conditioning. It is used for human beings, comfort AC. So that is why this, usually the temperature of the water, it is around 4 to 7 degrees Celsius. Okay, you cannot go in negative because the water will freeze and it will form ice. So the temperature of the water, it is from 4 to 7 degrees Celsius. Then only If water is at that temperature, then only we can achieve inside the room the temperature of 16 degree or 22 degree, whatever is set by the consumer. Any doubts in these four cycles? Expansion tank. So here you can see this expansion tank, it is connected where? It is connected to the return chilled water. So this here you can see this is the return chilled water. It goes back to where? To the chiller. Okay, so what happens when the central air conditioning system is working? Water becomes chilled. Okay, so the volume of the water reduces. When volume of the water reduces, this expansion tank provides the water to the system. Now, when we are turning off the central AC, what will happen over the time? Water will heat up. If water temperature increases, water will expand. Okay, so excess water is there. That water, it is again sent back to the expansion tank. That is the function of this expansion tank. Okay, now this complete building, it can be managed with either it can be done manually. This system can be managed manually, or it can be managed with the help of building management system, which is called BMS. That is automated system. So their sensors will be there. So these are the type of chillers. Okay, whatever chiller you see on the bottom side, this can be there on the basement, or it can be there on the top side of the building as well. Usually it is kept on the basement side of the building. Okay, so this part where we have compressor, condenser, expansion valve and evaporator, it is called chiller. Okay, proper word is chiller. And there are two types of chiller. By looking at the chiller, you can understand whether it is air cooled or water cooled. So here you can see there are two shell and tube type of heat exchanger. So this is water cooled chiller. And this part you can see here, there will be the connections for water, okay, for condenser. And here you can observe this part. This is air cooled condenser. Okay, this is a chiller type. Okay, chilled, same it is chilled water air conditioning system. This is a chiller, but this is air cooled chiller. So here you can see these are the fins, and on the top side you can observe fans are there. So basically here air cooling is done, and on this side you can see this is water cooled chiller. We'll go back to the previous slide. Now you will be able to understand the complete system. Abhi hum log kya karte dekho. First we do, we have suppose four floors are there. Ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor. Okay, what is the exact procedure for designing the complete system? We will see that. For each room, we will do cooling load calculation. Okay, using E20 Excel sheet, cooling load calculation is done. Okay, where we take into account the windows, wall thickness, human being, office appliances, etc. Different sources of heating. Okay, that we take care, and we find what is the load in each and every room. Then based on that, we find what is the CFM. Okay, what is the CFM, cubic feet per minute of air required in each room. Then we go for duct calculation. Okay, we based on the layout of the building, which we get from architecture. Okay, there we design the duct layout appropriately, and based on that, we decide where the AHU room should be there. Okay, we design the ducting system, and from the ducting system, we find what capacity of fan should be used. Then we select fan. Okay, so based on the design itself, we are selecting the chiller. Okay, so based on the different room, we select the different type of chiller. Now what is done? Based on the different conditions. Okay, here you can see the water is divided. So suppose this water from the chiller here, it is at 7 degrees Celsius. So it is sent to the ground floor. Same 7 degrees Celsius water is sent to the first, second and third floor as well. And whatever heat is picked up, it is sent back through the return line to the chiller. Again in chiller, that water will be cooled. So this is the actual procedure in which the designing is taking place. So we have seen this in module 5, we design the air conditioning system. Then we design the duct. Then we go to the fan. We select air terminal units and so on. Like this the designing is done. Basically here chilled water, na, it is splitted. Aisa nahi hai ki yahan pe gaya water aur wahi water wapas upar ja raha hai. Here water enters, that partially the remaining water goes over here. Okay, so aisa nahi hoga ki yahan ka pick up karke heat wo upar ja raha hai. So that is why the chiller is designed according to that. Na, you can see the size of this chiller. It is very very large. घर का कॉम्प्रेसर देखो इतना सा रहेगा वो. ये वाला कॉम्प्रेसर देखो, दिस इज द कॉम्प्रेसर ऑन द टॉप साइड. हियर यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दिस इज कॉम्प्रेसर. इट इज वेरी बिग कॉम्प्रेसर. इट कैन हैंडल वेरी लार्ज टीयर्स. ओके, सो वी विल सी द महिंद्रा एयर कंडीशनिंग सेंट्रल एसी प्लांट नाउ. So we will take the example, a case study of Mahindra and Mahindra central AC plant. So this is the central AC plant. It is very old. That is why here reciprocating compressor is being used. So I'll show you the parts. This is the reciprocating compressor. Here you can see this is one cylinder, this is second cylinder. On the other side also there might be two cylinders. So this is the reciprocating compressor. Now here you can see this green line is coming. Okay, here color codings are done. This green line is for condenser water line, and you can see blue line. This blue line is for chilled water. Okay, so here you can observe this condenser, it is connected to these two tubing. Okay, so condenser water, it will enter in the shell and tube heat exchanger. So what are the four components over here? This is compressor. This front side we have condenser, in between we have expansion valve, and on the back side we have evaporator which is insulated. We will see that part. Okay, so here you can see this green pipeline. This is the water coming from the terrace. Okay, cold water which is taken from the cooling tower. Okay, so it enters over here. Next, this is the compressor, back side of the compressor. So after compressor, the refrigerant enters the condenser which is there on the bottom side. You can see this, this is the outlet of the compressor. From the top side here, this is the outlet of the compressor, and from here this compress refrigerant, it goes to the condenser. Okay, so here you can see this pipe, it goes to the condenser. Okay, so this is the condenser part on the bottom side, where you can see this is shell and tube type of condenser. Here you can see there are two tubings in which one will be the supply pool water, and it will pick up the heat from refrigerant. Refrigerant will get condensed, and again the warm water, it is sent back to the terrace for cooling tower. Okay, so after condenser, the refrigerant, it will enter where? Here you can see this is the outlet. Inside the shell and tube type of condenser, shell side we have refrigerant. Okay, and inside the tube, cooling water is there. Now from the shell side, you can observe this refrigerant, it is coming out from the condenser, and it goes here to the expansion valve. This is the expansion valve. So here you can observe, this is the thermostatic expansion valve. And this part, it is the evaporator or chiller. Okay, it is insulated. This part is of black color. Okay, so insulation is there on this evaporator. Okay, then if you observe the evaporator, the refrigerant will enter the evaporator. The refrigerant will chill the water. So in the tube, refrigerant is there, and on the shell side water is there which is being chilled. Okay, now the refrigerant, it will vaporize, and you can see this black color, this is insulation pipe, insulated pipe. It again goes back to the compressor inlet. So this is the compressor inlet and this is the compressor outlet. Now if you observe, this is the bottom side is the evaporator. Okay, there are two blue colored piping. Okay, one pipe, it enters the chiller. Okay, it comes from there, it comes after picking up the heat from the AHU, it will come back over here. And from here, the chilled water which is going out, it will again be sent where? To the air handling unit. So from here, from this evaporator, you can see here there are two piping. One will be the return one and one will be the supply chilled water. Okay, now here you can see these again, these piping, these are made up of green color. Okay, so these pipings are taken to the terrace. Okay, these are the cooling water piping. Okay, and you can observe this is the natural convection type of cooling tower. I have already shown you this peak before as well. So this is from Mahindra and Mahindra plant. So what will happen, the water, it will go to the top. Here you can see the pipe, and on the top side there are nozzles. We have seen the peak of nozzles as well. So there the water is sprayed, and these are the louvers at certain angles. So air will enter from here, it will pick up the heat. Water will be cooled to atmospheric condition. Water will be collected on the bottom side. There will be float valve with the help of which makeup water is added, again with the help of condenser water pump. We use condenser water pump over here. So again with the help of condenser water pump, this is taken back where? To the condenser. Now we will see the AHU part. This is the AHU part. This is AHU room. Here you can see there are two lines. Okay, one it is going to the AHU and one it is taken back to the central AC, the chiller part. So from chiller this line is coming, it will go inside the AHU. inside the AHU there will be cooling coil. Okay, and exit of the cooling coil, again that water is coming from here and again it will go where? To the chiller. Okay, what is chiller? I have shown you the pic. This is chiller. Okay, so these are the two pipings. So these are the two pipings. Now here water, chilled water is entering the AHU. Here you can see this is volume control damper, VCD, which I had told you before. And on the top side, these are galvanized sheet ducting system. So from here, you can see this is the top side of the AHU. It can be any type of duct. It can be supply duct. It can be return duct. Okay, anything. But you can see basically here ducting arrangement is also shown. Now we will see the inside part of the AHU. Okay, here you can see filters are provided. So whatever air is there, it is first filtered. Okay, so air is filtered. It will enter inside. Okay, now after the filter, immediately we have cooling coils. Okay, inside the cooling coil, what is flowing? The chilled water, it is flowing inside the cooling coil. It will pick up the heat from the air and again it is sent back to the chiller. Okay, cooling water. Then here you can see a motor is shown. Okay, we'll see this pic. Here there is a fan motor and here there is a blower. Okay, here we have a V belt. It is the motor is being connected to the blower. And this blower, it is connected to the ducting system. And from here, there will be ducting system. And through the ducting system, there will be that ducting system will take the chilled air to the room side where there will be supply air diffuser. And the chilled air will be supplied to the room. Again, that chilled air, after picking up the heat, it will come back through the return air diffuser, through the return air duct back to the AHU. Okay, so there are multiple openings in AHU. Again, the air will come back. So fresh air is taken from the filter side, okay, and return air, it will come from duct, and one duct will be for supply air. I hope now everything is clear. Aap log abhi sab barabar se pura system ko samajh pa rahe ho. Like whatever you have studied before, now you are able to connect the dots, right? Jo pehle hum logon ne padha tha, ducting system tha, jo hum logon ne cooling load calculation kiya tha. So you are now, you should be now able to join all the dots with the help of this central air conditioning system. Okay, next we will see some images of water cooled and air cooled chiller from Acrex. So here you can observe, this is a latest model of water cooled chiller. Okay, this black color part, it is insulated. So this will be what? It will be evaporator. Okay, this part, bottom side, you can see both are shell and tube type of heat exchangers. Okay, top side, which is top one, which is insulated with black color. Okay, you can even see the return line to the compressor. This top part is the compressor. Okay, this is compressor. Bottom side, this is condensers. Okay, then expansion valve is there and this black color portion is evaporator. And this is the return to the compressor. Okay, so this will be which type of chiller? It will be water cooled chiller. Okay, why? Because here both the heat exchanger, the condenser is which type of condenser? Water cooled condenser. We have shell and tube type of condenser. Next, we will see air cooled chiller. So here you can observe these are the fins. Okay, inside there will be fin and top side you can observe these black color circular portions. Okay, these are the fans. Okay, this is the inside. Here you can observe these are the fins. Okay, so this is air cooled and water cooled chiller. Next, we will see in brief what is air handling unit. Okay, so there are two types of air handling unit. One is draw through type. And second one is blow through type. So what happens in draw through type? You can observe initially there will be filter and cooling coil, it is before the fan. So in draw through type of system, air is drawn through the cooling coil and then it is sent to the application. Okay, whereas in blow through type, the outside air and return air mixes, it gets filtered and then both the air, it is moving over the cooling coil. Okay, so it is blown over the cooling coil. So that is why this is called blow through unit. Whereas here the air is drawn over the cooling coil. So you can observe what is the difference over here, location of cooling coil, or you can say location of the fan. Here the fan is there after the cooling coil. Okay, so air is drawn over the cooling coil. Whereas if you see the second blow through, here the fan is before the cooling coil. So air is blown over the cooling coil. Okay, now this type of air handling unit, here you can observe this is mostly used in pharmaceutical industries. Okay, here you can observe on the top side return air is there, which is coming from the top side, and from here fresh air is entering. Now here there is a box where we have combination filters from 10 microns to 3 microns. Then after filter we have a cooling coil where cooling is done. Then we have UVGI. We have already seen what is UVGI. To reduce the bacteria content, we have UVGI, and that this UV light, it is thrown on this cooling coil. Okay, so cooling coil as well as it will go, it might go to the filter area as well. So because of that, bacteria level is minimized. Okay, then here we have blower. Okay, and cooling coil is before this. So this is which type? Cooling coil is before. So it is draw through type of AHU. Okay, then again there is a filter which is called HEPA filter. Okay, what is this HEPA filter and ULPA filter, we will see later on. And these are 0.3 micron filter. Okay, again filtration is done, and here there is a opening, and from there the air is supplied as a supply air. Okay, so this is air handling unit used in pharmaceutical industries. Same thing is shown over here again. We have outdoor air, return air, a filter is there. Initially a filter is there, preheating coil and so on. So there are different types of AHU. Preheating is also done sometimes in AHU. It depends.